Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your NFL Thanksgiving commentary between the Lions and the Vikings as we have Law and Order Case Keenum throwing a touchdown pass to Kyle Rudolph, not the red-nosed reindeer, for the touchdown for the Vikings.
When you get 4 stars on GTA, who comes with the police? The SWAT! As the Detroit Lions block the Vikings for the extra point. Hey, Kai Forbath, it's not like you're gonna get blocked again, right?
On the ensuing Lions drive, their offense must have just got castrated because they forget the ball and it's recovered by the Minnesota Vikings. Long ago, there was a running back in Detroit who can do it all, but when they needed him most, he vanished. 2 plays later, the Vikings open their Bibles to the Genesis of Dreadlocks 5-2. In Pokemon Gold and Silver, you can catch Ho-Oh in the Tin Towers. Even with mini dreadlocks, you still have power. As Jerick McKinnon goes inside the 10 and it seems he fumbles the ball into the air, it's caught by Adam Thielen for what appears to be a Vikings touchdown. The referees aren't too sure what to do here as they deliberate. Hey, anybody got the Lions defense on fantasy? I got Adam Thielen. I have Adam Thielen too. What about you over there? Yeah, I got Thielen too. Let's just give him the touchdown. I want those points. Touchdown, Vikings! But upon further review, it was way too evident that Jerick McKinnon was down by contact, so they have to go out there and reverse the score.
After reviewing the footage, we have evidence that he was down by contact. When was the last time we even took evidence seriously? I mean, it didn't work for OJ, but we'll take the points off the board.
On the following play, the Vikings are in that Jaw zone, Rosetta Stone house, a motherfucker, as Case Keenum takes the ball himself into the end zone for the Vikings touchdown. Following a sack in the second quarter, Everson Griffin of the Minnesota Vikings had a question to ask the world. I just had a baby boy. What should I name him? I have a suggestion. Later on that exact same drive, Matthew Stafford is looking to hit Theo Riddick for the easy walk-in touchdown, but he drops the ball on the floor. Remember when they had good receivers? Jesus, stop calling me. Release me from my contract. I do not want to be a Detroit Lion. Leave me alone. Following the drop, the Lions have to settle for a 32-yard field goal. Matt Prater lines up and kicks it through the uprights, and it's good. Blair Walsh, I have a better chance seeing Charles Manson next to Jesus in heaven than seeing you make a kick. Put your motherfucking head back down. It seems the Vikings have got 5 stars on GTA again because the SWAT team shows up once more, as Kai Forbath's second field goal is blocked. My man, that's 2 in 1 game. Right before halftime, the Lions defense has to stop the Vikings one time, but they ain't shit as Kyle Rudolph catches a touchdown for the second time. On the following drive, the Lions have the ball at their own 25-yard line, and Matthew Stafford is looking to go deep. Kenny Golladay catches his ball out of the air the same way Charlie Sheen catches a STD. Look at the replay. Forget a 10 toes down challenge. This is a drowning pool, let your bodies hit the floor challenge for the reception. The Lions are in the Pygon zone, Rosetta Stone Korean motherfucker, as Matthew Stafford connects with Marvin Jones and they just break the plane like Sam Witwicky did to Starscream in Transformers Dark of the Moon. Touchdown, Lions! To open up the third quarter, Case Keenum turns around and hands the ball to Latavius Murray. He makes a couple of moves and he's loose in the open field, running away from the Lions defense faster than LiAngelo Ball can ruin a college scholarship at UCLA. A couple plays later, the Vikings are in the period colored zone. They hand the ball to Latavius Murray and he penetrates the Lions vulva region for a Vikings touchdown. To open up the fourth quarter, Matthew Stafford drops back and he throws the ball to Marvin Jones, and oh my god, you can call the Vikings defense Rodney Dangerfield because they don't get no respect at all. Let's say together, hold my nuggets, suck my dick. Marvin Jones goes into the end zone for the touchdown. It's about the time the Vikings activate their genjutsu powers and they catch the Lions defense in a tsukuyomi as they're nowhere to be found as Stephon Diggs runs all the way down the field to the 20-yard line. On the following drive, Matthew Stafford is checking the receipt on his ejaculate because he's trying to get a comeback, and he throws the ball but it's intercepted by Xavier Rhodes. He's returning it to the 20-yard line. Did you think the Lions would be better this year? Did you think the Lions were going to win the game? Bopped your whole head. They the same bum-ass Lions of old. Matthew Stafford, put your head down. Matter of fact, pick it up. I want you to take a look at the intercom to see that your train is on the horizon. Swipe your Metro card. You and the Detroit Lions, board the L train. All of y'all motherfuckers need to put your goddamn head down. I'd rather take relationship advice from Taylor Swift than expect the Lions to come back and win this game. You goddamn bums. No Thanksgiving turkey for you. Drink your own saliva. Oh.